Skip it up and that up.
Man, oh man, oh man. What a night last night was. The drama still continues, but last night was hell. So I come home from running errands, and I go to my computer. Actually, I saw it on my cell phone, I should say. Check on my email, and I see I have two strikes, copyright strikes, on my YouTube account. And I'm like, what the fuck is that about? So I look into the, I'm going to name absolutely nothing from the person who put these strikes on my account. I don't want anyone going after them. It's already being handled. I just want people to understand what's going on. Leave them be. It's not worth it. There's a 99.9999% chance this is all going to be resolved. The strikes are going to be removed, whatever the case may be. So 9 of my videos were taken down. 9 of my recent videos. So I'm like, what the hell is going on? So I look into this company, and this company had a page, and there were people commenting on the page saying that they were also getting false copyright claims. So there was someone going on a rampage. Okay. Now, all of a sudden, I post on Twitter that this company that doesn't seem too legit is claiming my videos and getting me to get copyright. They were taking my videos down and getting strikes on my account. Well, the person who supposedly owns this company responded. And this person said, the explosion, the license-free explosion that I have been using for almost 4 years, if not more than 4 years, in my intro, okay, is what they own. I couldn't make this up if I tried. So this said person, all right, told me to send them an email. Okay, we'll discuss this through email. They go on to say, if you want to keep using that explosion, you need to pay me a monthly fee, or you need to pay me a buyout fee. So basically, I was being blackmailed. I'm like, do you have any proof at all that you own this explosion that I got license free 4 years ago? I need to know. I can't give that away, but I can give you this. And they copy and paste some random source code in an email. I'm like, what the fuck does this have to do with a fiery explosion? But sure, okay. So I pass these emails off to my manager, and he looks at me. He's like, what does this have to do with fucking anything? So he goes, and he actually said he looked up the code. It's for some other program that has nothing to do with the intro explosion. So he actually contacted this person. And then they backed off like, oh, we just don't use the explosion again. I just don't want you using it anymore. We could be on our way. Now, the shit kicker of all this is, okay, this said person and this anonymous company, which I will not name, all right, they said that, oh, we just found your channel. That's why we just did the copyright claims now. Well, it was funny. The YouTube channel that they owned, there was a subscriber of mine who was very nice to find it for me, had a video from a year ago of them having a video up with me debating Blockbuster Critic or talking to Blockbuster Critic. The video is now gone because they got caught with their pants down. They probably deleted it right away, which sad day for you is that even when you delete a video, YouTube still has it in their database. So when this claim goes through, or this counterclaim goes through, they're going to look into that. They deleted the video, though, so no one could see it. Also, too, this said person, again, tweeted me over a year ago, or about, no, June of 2014, they tweeted me. So they've known who I've been for a very long time. So they've seen this explosion. Why magically now it has become a problem? Yeah. Also, too, this person has like 3 different names. It's a pile of fucking bullshit. It's someone who has a chip on their shoulder about me. And instead of going about it the proper way, they went about it this way. They attacked and did nothing else. It's obviously an attack on my channel. If they, first off, if you were looking to be compensated, there's so many other things too. I'm going to get super technical. That if you were looking to be compensated, the more devastating thing you could have done is claimed all the videos, which I would have gotten revoked, removed anyway. But you could have claimed all the videos and gotten the monetization from them. So if you really wanted to get paid, Mr. Anonymous Person, you could have gotten paid that way, and you would have made a lot more money than what you asked me for. Which basically, if you walk on the side of the road for 3 hours, you would have found the same amount. The bottom line is the explosion is royalty free, and even if it wasn't royalty free, it falls under fair use. It's not even like I'm just using the explosion. I have my logo in there, another picture. There's so many other things going on. It's the epitome of fair use, which is funny on top of it, because this person who is crying copyright foul, which again is obviously complete bullshit, has pictures of celebrities on their profile, which is the same thing. You're doing the same thing you're going trying to go after me for. So look, there's two other things I want to talk about. I don't want this video to go into double digit times here. One, this is why the broken copyright laws of the United States need to be fixed. The DMCA, all this other crap, it's shoot first, ask questions later. A lot of people point fingers at YouTube, but if YouTube didn't do their system this way, to adhere to the broken United States copyright laws, they would shut down. They have to just take videos down. They have to just do this, because the record industry and the movie industry would just have them in court all day. They would be in court 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. This is the way it has to be done. You could thank the broken US copyright laws for the way that YouTube works. People point fingers at YouTube, but you have to point fingers at the government first before you point them at YouTube. Secondly, in case some other issue happens and my account gets temporarily suspended or temporarily shut down, I will have a link to another one of my channels below in the description. So, which, because I'm sure as my channel gets larger, this is going to happen again. If it does ever happen, you could go there and I'll upload just like I upload to Review Tech USA. I may only have one video up there in the meantime, because it's not good. That's going to be my auxiliary channel, but yeah, go subscribe to that one. If you see my channel magically disappears, you'll see videos uploaded on there. Also, too, when this gets squared away, I'm thinking of more so directing this secondary channel below to be a sexy Coco channel. So I know my friend Nick has been suggesting I make a second channel. So here you go. Here it is. So if you ever see my channel is magically gone, it's not that I went MIA. It's just that some BS like this happened. So go check the second channel below, subscribe to it, and you will also see videos there. Oh yeah, one more thing, Mr. or Mrs. Anonymous Person. Was this the explosion you were talking about?
Skip it up and that up.
Or was it this one?
Skip it up and that up.
Oh, I'm sorry. It must have been this one.
Skip it up and that up.
Piss off.